When you learned about addition way back in elementary school, you probably learned that the order in which you add things doesn't matter. You know, if you want to add 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4, well, that's the same thing as adding 3 plus 1 plus 4 plus 2. You can scramble the terms in whatever order you want, and it just doesn't matter. And that's true whenever you have a finite number of terms. But what happens if you have an infinite number of terms? That is, what happens if you have an infinite series? And the idea is, if you have something that converges absolutely, then scrambling the order doesn't change the sum. And the reason was what we described in the last video. If it converges absolutely, there's only a finite amount of positive stuff. There's only a finite amount of negative stuff. Rearrange it however you like. You still get all of the positive stuff and all of the negative stuff, and you take the difference, and that's your answer. On the other hand, if you have something that converges conditionally, the order matters a lot. So the rest of this video is going to be working through a particular example of a conditionally convergent series, and we're going to change the order around, and we're going to get different answers. So let's start off with the series. The series is going to be, you take 1 and subtract 1, then add a half and subtract a half, then add a half again and subtract a half, add a third and subtract a third, do that 3 times, add a fourth and subtract a fourth, do that 4 times, add a fifth and subtract a fifth, do that 5 times, add a sixth and subtract a sixth, do that 6 times. You get the idea. Well, this is an alternating series. It goes plus, minus, plus, minus, plus, minus, and the terms are getting smaller. You have 1, if you look at the size of the terms, it's 1, 1, a half, a half, a half, a half, a third, a third, a third, a third, a third, a third, a fourth, 8 times, a fifth, 10 times, a sixth, 12 times. So, and these get smaller and smaller and smaller, so it's an alternating series, it converges, and you can see what it converges to, because it's 1 minus 1 is 0, plus a half minus a half is 0, plus a half minus a half is 0, plus a third minus a third is 0. You get the idea. All the even sums, S2, S4, S6, S8, they're all 0. And all the odd sums approach 0 from above. So the limit is 0. On the other hand, what if we scrambled things a little bit? We'll still take 1 minus 1. But now when we deal with the halves, let's put the plus a halves first and then all the minus a halves. When we get the thirds, let's put the plus a thirds first and then the minus a thirds. And then we'll take 4 plus a fourths and then the 4 minus a fourths. And then the 5 plus a fifths and the 5 minus a fifths. And if you keep track of what the partial sums are, you have 1 minus 1 makes 0, plus a half makes a half, plus a half makes 1. Minus a half makes a half, minus a half makes 0. A third, 2/3, 1. 2/3, 1/3, 0. A quarter, a half, 3/4, 1. 3/4, a half, 1/4, 0. 1/5, 2/5, 3/5, 4/5, 5/5. 4/5, 3/5, 2/5, 1/5, 0/5. So what happens to the partial sums is that they go up from 0 to 1, and then they come back down to 0. And then they go back up to 1, and it comes down to 0. And there's no limit. This is not a convergent series. It's a divergent series. It's not divergent in the sense that it goes to infinity or minus infinity. It's divergent in the sense that it never settles down. But you can see that it's got the exact same terms as the original series. It has plus 1/2 twice, and minus a half twice, and plus a third 3 times, and minus a third 3 times, and so on. All we've done is we've changed the order, and we've managed to take this perfectly nice convergent series and turn it into a divergent series. Here's another way to rearrange things. You see, if you look at all the positive terms, you have 1, a half and a half, that's 1, a third, that's 1, a fourth 4 times, that's 1. You got 1 and 1 and 1 and 1 and 1 and 1 and 1. There's an infinite amount of positive stuff. And likewise, there's an infinite amount of negative stuff. And we're going to rearrange things to give the positive stuff a head start. We'll take the 1, and then we're going to put the minus 1 in the middle of the 2 halves. Then we're going to put the minus a halves in the middle of the 3 thirds. And we're going to put the minus a thirds in the middle of the quarters. And so we gave the plus side a head start, so here we get 1. And then this stuff adds up to 0. And this stuff adds up to 0. And this stuff adds up to 0. And the next line adds up to 0. Because it's 5 fifths minus 4 quarters. And you discover that this converges, but it doesn't converge to 0 like the first term. It converged to 1. By rearranging the order of the terms, we changed the answer. Weird. Likewise, it turns out that by rearranging the orders of the terms, you can get any number that you want to be the answer, or you can get it to diverge to infinity, diverge to minus infinity, or oscillate and not converge to anything at all. The moral of the story. If you have a series that is absolutely convergent, that's robust. You can rearrange terms as much as you like. It's unambiguous. There's a certain amount of positive stuff. There's a certain amount of negative stuff. There's a certain amount of total stuff. If you have something that's conditionally convergent, then you've got an infinite amount of positive stuff and an infinite amount of negative stuff. And the only reason it converged is that there was this delicate balance between the positive stuff and the negative stuff. And if you change the order, you mess up the balance, and all sorts of crazy things can happen.